Hello friends, welcome to EPG Paathshala. I am Dr. Ramasuray Prasad from Department of Geography of Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar College, University of Delhi. Today, I am going to elaborate upon glacial and periglacial landscapes, which comes under the paper geomorphology. First of all, let us discuss what could be the learning outcome of this module. While going through this module, you will be able to explain the formation of glacier, distinguish between alpine and continental glacier, describe the movement of an alpine glacier, explain various features formed by erosional work of glacier, explain various features formed by depositional works of glacier, and identify the different types of moraine and their formation. Now, let us see about the glacial and periglacial conditions. Glacial condition exists where the temperature is always less than 0 degrees Celsius. Mostly, precipitation occurs in the form of snowfall in the glacial areas. The annual amount of snow melt is less than or equal to annual snowfall over the area. If snowfall is more, the glaciated area is on rise, but when it is equal to the snowfall, it is stagnant. When the snowfall is less than the snow melt, the glaciated area is on decline. Glaciated areas always bear the ice on the surface. It is not so only when the slope is too high to sustain the ice. The accumulated ice is on slide downward. In this way, it develops a large number of features. Periglacial condition exists in the periglacial areas of the glaciated region. In this zone, the annual average temperature is around 0 degrees Celsius. In winter, there is a thin layer of ice and a snow accumulation, but it is not the same during summer days. Even during summer days, the subsurface moisture content is found to be in a frozen condition. In the soil zone, the temperature is less than 0 degrees Celsius. Freezing and thawing is a normal condition which is main cause of weathering here. Both glacial and periglacial conditions are quite different from each other. Now, let us see what the glaciated areas are. Glaciers are found on all the continents except Australia. Their widespread existence is in polar areas because of the favorable condition for the accumulation of ice. Since the Arctic is an ocean around the North Pole, the amount of glacial ice is widely variable with changing seasons. But the ice survives throughout the year. The land parts is in periphery of the Arctic Ocean like northern Canada, Alaska, Greenland and northern Eurasian region have sustaining glaciers. These land masses have glaciers throughout the year. The direction of the flow of ice is outward as per the slope of the area. Almost whole of the Antarctic continent is situated south of Arctic Circle. Its 98% area is covered with ice and only 2% have bare rocks. The Antarctic has ice sheet with an average thickness of around 2.16 kilometers. The maximum thickness at Terra Adélie is recorded to be 4,776 meter, almost half of the coastal fringe area is free from ice. Huge icebergs float on the ocean waters, particularly in summer season between November to February for the southern hemisphere. About 80% area of Greenland is under the ice cover. The cross section drawn on the map of Greenland and Antarctic has been drawn and the thickness of the ice cover is clearly seen, which is given in the following figure. We know that the effect of temperature is progressively reduced with increasing altitude. It is the highest air temperature recorded at sea level and keeps on declining with increasing height. The distribution of temperature is also affected by the inclination of the sun rays. Due to this reason, the air temperature keeps on declining with increasing latitudes. That is why the permanent snow line is different at different latitudes. Therefore, the ice is available at different altitudes at different places with changing latitudes. In polar regions, it is available at the ground level. In equatorial zone, it is found 5 km above the mean sea level, whereas in temperate zone, it is 1 km to 5 km. In Central Africa at Kilimanjaro, it is found to be about 5,500 meters. On Himalayas, it is between 4,500 to 6,000 meters and on Alps, it is 2,800 meters above mean sea level. Therefore, glaciers are found at the higher latitude at the mountain ranges, even in the tropical and temperate regions of the world. The entire frozen water of the globe is termed as cryosphere. The cryosphere constitutes of ice and snow occupying the earth's surface, mountains, rivers, lakes and oceans. The total amount of water stored in the cryosphere is about 2% of the total hydrosphere. Out of the total area under ice is 85.3% on Antarctic and 13.27% in Arctic region. Both constitutes 98.57% of the glaciated area of the globe. Rest of about 1.5% of the glaciated area is in other parts of the world. The details of the distribution of glaciers are given in the table 1. Now let us talk about glacier. Glacier is a creeping mass of ice. It moves very slowly. Immediate apparent movement of the glacier is difficult to perceive. It takes a longer time to see the movement. The movement happens under the influence of gravity to the downslope direction. Since the glaciers are solid mass and have enormous capacity to erode the rock and transport the rock fragments, in this process, they sculpture significant features creating distinct landscape. But before coming to the landscapes, let us discuss about the types and their methods of erosion and transportation. Types of glacier. Mountain glaciers. The accumulation of ice over the mountain slope covering large areas is called mountain glacier. It is the outward flow of ice from the ice field encompassing several peaks of the surrounding areas. It is mostly narrow and long because it occupies the pre-existing river valleys. In the higher altitude, the temperature is very low, but as long as it comes down, the temperature keeps on increasing. This leads to ablation or breaking of glacier into ice pieces and ultimately melting. They are generally termed to that glacier which are found on the mountains of tropical and temperate region. Glaciers are also found in the mountains of the polar region, but generally they are termed as polar glaciers because they occupy big continuous area of the ice accumulation. Valley glaciers. Valley glacier is a narrow strip of ice accumulation confined within the two walls of pre-existing river valley. Valley glaciers are almost found on the mountain slopes. Sometimes Both of them are used as synonyms, but they have slight difference. Mountain glaciers are huge in size, whereas the valley glaciers are small in size, and the ice is restricted within the two banks of the previously carved out river valleys. The downside terminating glacier is tongue shaped, that is, a smoothened and round in appearance. Both of them are known as alpine glaciers. In fact, alpine glaciers originate from the mountain summits and descends through the mountain valleys. Valley glaciers are very short in comparison to the continental glaciers. The longest of this type is less than 80 kilometer long. The smallest may be of a few hundred meters, Piedmont Glacier. When the ice mass moving through the steep surface of the mountain reaches the foothills or the plain area, it creates Piedmont Glacier. Piedmont means an area from the foothills to the flat plain land. The confined ice of the valley glacier is forced to spread over a larger area because of lowering of the slope. It takes the shape of bulbs like lobes, continental glacier. A continuous sheet of ice occupying a very large area is known as continental glacier. The movement of the continental glacier is normally from the center towards outward all directions. Relatively, a small sized continental glaciers are known as ice fields. Similarly, a big sized continental mass of glaciers covering enormous area is called ice sheets. Almost whole of the Antarctic and Greenland are covered with ice sheets. A thick mass of ice and snow forming a glacier over a great deal of area is termed as ice cap. It may develop over the continental or on mountain glacier. Continental glaciers are very long and large in comparison to the valley glaciers. The longest continental polar glacier is more than 500 kilometer. Now let us talk a little bit about the anatomy of the alpine glacier. Alpine glacier is concerned with the mountain glacier found in different continents at varying altitudes. Uppermost section is characterized by zone of accumulation of ice due to extreme cold condition. Intermediaries is characterized by greater rock plucking from the glacial valley and abrasion. A steep slope is associated with crack in the ice blocks called crevasses. Lowermost zone is accompanied by melting of ice due to increase in temperature. This is known as zone of ablation. In this zone, the load carried by the glacier is deposited, popularly known as moraine. Over the years, a sort of equilibrium of ice accumulation is maintained. Now, let us discuss about the work of glaciers. The glaciers perform their work in three different ways: erosion, transportation, and deposition. Now, it is erosion. Glacier perform its erosional works primarily in two ways: plucking and abrasion. When any sort of irregularity is found in the way of glacier, the solid mass of ice exerts enormous pressure. The pressure plucks and crushes the rock in the way. It becomes easier when the jointed rocks are found. This process is termed as plucking or quarrying. The plucked rocks or the fragmented rocks materials available keep on moving along with the moving ice. Once that material moves along the side or the bed of the glacier, they erode the surface. This leads to a scratching of the bed as well as reduction of the moving material in their size. This process is termed as abrasion. Both plucking and abrasion is very prominent. Now, talking about the factors affecting the rate of glacial erosion. There are several factors affecting the glacial erosion, like thickness of ice, topography, geology of the area, temperature, velocity of the glacier, slope, amount of ice, accumulation, and ablation, etc. Transportation. The work of transportation by glacier is performed in three ways. When the weathered rocks material fall on the glaciers, they are transported on the ice surface. Slowly and slowly, a part of the materials fall below the ice surface and are transported for a considerable distance. Some of the rock fragments moves further downward and reaches to the bottom of the glacier. Based on the position of the rock fragments, they are categorized into three. The first one is said to be the surface, that is supraglacial. The second to be internal, that is inglacial, and the third to be abyssal, that is subglacial deposition. The eroded and transported load of the glacier is deposited when the carrying capacity is reduced. The carrying capacity is reduced due to slope reduction or melt of ice and further lowering of the mass of ice. In both the cases, the deposition is evident. The deposition by glacier is very distinct because it is unsorted and ungraded deposits of the load of the glacier. Depending upon the place and material of the deposits, they may be categorized into several groups about which it will be dealt while dealing with the landforms. Now, coming to the erosional landforms. A number of landforms are created due to erosion by glaciers. Important among them are the following. Cirque. The shape of the cirque is just like an armchair, and it is being made by glacial erosion. When the glacier descends from the mountain slope, it moves faster due to very steep slope. Later, when the slope lowers, the excessive accumulation of ice exerts enormous pressure and the base is eroded by ice rotation. Plucking and abrasion. In due course of time, the base is further eroded and a depression is created. It is called cirque, which is a French term and meant for a circle or bowl shaped. It is also known as quarry or Scottish in Scottics. Arethes. When several cirques or quarries are developed on different sides of a mountain peak, their separating boundaries are further narrowed and sharpened. The sharp knife or blade edged boundaries are called arethes. Mountain climbers generally follow arethes for scaling the peak. Col. Col is a depression like feature made between two peaks. Generally, col is made by the erosive action of glacier. The depression is created by the moving glacier. It helps in passing the mountain from one side to another. Col is also known as pass or saddle. Saddle is a seat fastened on the back of a horse for sitting and riding the horse. It is depressed at the center but raised in front and the rear, and hence it is called so. Horn or pyramidal peak. When the glaciers are developed from different sides of a peak, they erode the pre-existing surface of the peak successively and make it a sharp and pointed peak. with very steep slope. This gives a rise of a pyramidal peak, which is also termed as horn, as it is very pointed. Hanging Valley. Hanging Valley is a tributary valley glacier of a main glacier. Main glacier has huge amount of ice, hence erode the base greater. Therefore, the main glacial valley is much deeper. The tributary glacier has lesser amount of ice, hence lesser erosion. Therefore, the base of the tributary glacier remains above the main glacier valley. When the glaciation is over, the tributary valley is seen above the main valley. That is why it is called Hanging Valley. Truncated spur. A spur is a long tongue-shaped ridge dropping down in an inverted V separating the two adjacent valleys. The valley's confluence with another main river, when the same area comes under the influence of glacier, that is due to climate change, the main river turns into main glacier. Volume of ice in the main glacier is very large. It erodes its valley greater. Since the glacier is the moving solid ice, it erodes not only the bed but sides also. The drop down spur is eroded and the slope of a spur is interrupted. This interrupted broken spur is called truncated spur, U-shaped valley. Glacial ice movement erodes its sides and make the trough much wider. The bed of the glacier is flat and both sides are almost vertical. This elongated wider trough is called U-shaped valley. When the glaciation period is over and ice is melted, the valley is exposed. Fjord. Fjords are submerged glacial valley under the sea water along the coast. The bottom of the valley is cut down because of heavy accumulated ice movement even below the sea level. With the culmination of ice age, the sea level also rises and down cut glaciated valleys along the sea coast and drown under the sea water. Because of this process, the coast is greatly dissected. This sort of coasts are found in the high latitudes and near the polar areas. Now, let us discuss about the depositional landforms. Numerous landforms are created due to deposition of glacial loads when its capacity to carry is reduced. Important among them are the following. Moraine. The materials carried by the glacial ice is deposited in the ideal condition when the carrying capacity is reduced. These deposits are generally unsorted and unstratified as it is deposited as and when the material reaches and dropped. Most of them are boulders of different sizes. Depending on the place of deposits, the moraines are classified into different groups. They are lateral moraine. The two sides of the glacier edge generally have exposed rocks. The weathered materials are dropped at the side of the glacier and are transported along. Materials are also supplied due to landslide as well. Carried materials also erode the side of the glacier and furthermore loads are generated. These materials are deposited along the side of the glacier and hence they are called lateral moraine. Medial moraine. When tributary glacier or two glaciers meet with each other, the meeting sides lateral moraines are joined together and moves further downward. Slowly and slowly, the joined lateral moraine reaches towards the middle, near middle. When the ice melts, the joint lateral moraine is deposited and is called medial moraine, terminal moraine. The deposits which occur at the down end of the glacier in a ridge like accumulation, these debris are pushed forward by advancing glacial tongue and dropped at the end. The terminal moraine spreads over one side of the bank of the glacier to another, covering the entire width. It appears like a belt of a small hilly ground with knobs and joints. Recessional moraine. Recessional moraine is a sort of a terminal moraine. After the formation of terminal moraine, when the glacier retreats, a new terminal moraine is formed at upstream. The previous terminal is later called as recessional down moraine, ground moraine. Irregular blankets of glacial loads deposited on the floor of a rolling to flat landscape after glacial melt retreat is called ground moraine. As the term itself explains, it is the whole of the ground downside the existing glacier where the glacial load is deposited. It is formed in both the cases, continental glacier and valley glacier. Ground moraine is also known as till plain, glacial till and till plain. The glacier carries huge amount of loads with it. When the glacier melts or retreats, the transported load are deposited. This deposit is undulating to flat in look. The deposition of such material at a certain location at a small scale is till, and the widespread area containing till is termed as till plain. This type of till plain is very extensive in continental glacier but confined in the valley glaciers. Outwash plain. Downside from the glacial melt, water associated with a small piece of ice floats below. Gravels, sands, shales and clays are carried downward by the melted water and deposited far away. It forms a slopy but relative flat plain known as outwash plain. Generally we call material washed or carried by the water. It is different from till plain. Till plain has unsorted materials directly deposited by melt of ice and hence dropped without ordering of the size of the materials. Outwash plain has sorted deposits as it is deposited by glaciofluvial action, and in this a small piece of ice as well as water flows. Iskar. Iskar is a long, narrow and zigzag ridge like a structure generally made up of stratified sediments deposited by subglacial meltwater. Its height varies from 5 meter to 50 meter and width is 50 meter to 500 meter, whereas the length may be 500 meter to many kilometers. Iskar is not necessarily a continuous feature, but it may be a detached or broken. Literally, it is a deposited by the meltwater of the glacier and hence they are shorted. Kettle. A kettle is a shallow and a small pothole or depression area in which glacial brought sediment is deposited and remaining hollow part covers the water. It is formed and appear on the surface by retreating glacier. Probably this depression is created by the plucking, but later the deposition of sediment and water accumulation give the birth of kettle. This water filled body is known as kettle lake. Cairn. came is the accumulation in a mound-like shape made up poorly sorted sand, boulders and gravels brought by glacier at its terminus. A number of cames is formed when the glacier melts and terminates or recedes. A group of closely formed cames are termed as came complex. Several crater lakes are seen in a came complex. Roc moutonné. It is a French word meant for woolly rock, but in English it means sheep back or sheep rock. Roc moutonné is a smoothened and bedrock of a glaciated region by abrasion in the upstream side and rough and steep surface of the downstream due to plucking or scoring. Once the area is free from glacier, the same feature appears on the surface. Drumlin. Drumlin is an elongated, oval-shaped deposited mound of a small hill-like feature formed by glacier. It is made up of glacial till containing boulders, gravels and sand transported by glacier and finally deposited in the above mentioned shape. They are seen in the plain and are many in number. They vary in dimension, like 1 to 2 kilometers in length, 400 to 600 meter in width and 15 to 30 meter in height. Let us have an overview of the erosional features. The important erosional and depositional features made by glacier is represented in the following diagram given below. Now, let us talk about the periglacial landscape. Periglacial refers to the area in the periphery of the glaciated region. During summer, the region is almost free from ice on the surface, but the subsurface is still frozen throughout the year. The seasonal freezing and thawing of subsoil is regular feature of the region. During winter, the surface witness heavy snowfall and the ice accumulation. In another words, the area is almost permanently frozen condition, but without permanent ice cover on the surface. The mean monthly temperature is below minus 1 degree Celsius to minus 15 degree Celsius. The periglacial areas changes with the change in the climatic condition prevailing on the planet. Based on the extent of freezing condition, the permafrost areas are classified into three groups: continuously permafrost, discontinuously permafrost, and sporadic permafrost and isolated permafrost. The surface layer where freezing and thawing is seen is known as active layer. The periglacial areas witness several processes. Important among are frost action, frost heave, frost shattering, indirectly leading to rock fall, earth flow and debris flow. Frost action. It is quite obvious that the volume of ice is greater than that of water. Freezing and thawing is a natural process. The water lying in the pores, cracks or opening expands and breaks the rock when it turns into ice. Therefore, weathering process is amplified by this process. Frost heave. When the subsoil water freezes, it leads to upward swelling of topsoil. This process is repeated time and again with changing season. Upper soil is loosened and subject to removal easily. Frost shattering. Freezing and thawing process is known as frost shattering. The water lying in the cracks of exposed rocks in cold climates leads to breaking it. Rockfall. Rockfall is a type of mass movement in which the fragmented rock tumble down almost freely. In the cold climates, the exposed rocks are fragmented by freezing and thawing action, and hence the credit of rockfall is credited to permafrost action. Earth flow and the debris flow. The availability of water content liquefies the soil, and if it is on the slope, it flows quickly. This action is seen in the periglacial areas as the meltwater of the ice triggers. Debris flow includes the unconsolidated soil, rock fragments, and remnants of biotic life along with water. When these are associated with slope, it leads to debris flow, and it is also triggered by water made available by snow melt in the periglacial areas. Now let us talk about the landforms in periglacial areas. Several types of landforms are found in periglacial areas. Some of them are patterned ground. Patterned ground is termed to that ground surface when the laying material are distributed in a certain pattern. The pattern may be of any kind, like stripes, ovals, circles, polygons. Particularly in the periglacial areas, they are made by frost heave action, ice wedges. The wedges mean pieces or slice or blocks. When the rocks are broken into pieces due to ice action, it is termed as ice wedges. In this situation, the water of ice penetrates vertically into surface for several meters. In cold climates, that is in periglacial areas, the seasonal freezing and thawing cause the rock to break and penetrate further downward during summer. In winter, it freezes, and further the space is widened, leading to rock breaking. Block fields. Block fields are areas of huge expanse constituting the freeze-thaw weathered angular rock blocks in periglacial areas. Rock blocks get disintegrated into smaller pieces, and thus angular rocks are seen on the surface. Pingos. Pingos are hills of earth and gravel in a dome shaped formed in the periglacial areas, under which the subsoil water freezing and tends to push the upper part upward. This height may vary from 5 meter to 70 meter, and the diameter from 30 meter to 1 kilometer. Most of the pingos are circular in shape. Now let us conclude this module. Glacier is a flowing body of ice moving slowly, as it is solid mass of water. Glaciers are found where the temperature is less than 0 degree Celsius throughout the year. Based on the location and situation, glaciers are grouped broadly into two: continental and ice glaciers. Continental glaciers are found in the polar region, occupying very large areas as well as huge accumulation of ice. Valley glaciers are located on the mountain slopes of tropical and temperate region on high altitudes and occupying very small areas with little ice. Moving ice erode the underlying rocks by plucking and abrasion. The generated loads are transported along the glacier. Later on, the same is deposited in certain conditions due to both erosion and deposition. Several types of landforms are created. Important among the erosional landforms are cirque, arete, coal, horn, Hanging Valley, Truncated Spur, U-shaped Valley, Fjord, etc. Some depositional landforms are moraines, till, till plain, outwash plain, esker, kettle, kettle lake, rock mutone, drumlin, etc. The peripheral areas of the glaciers are known as periglacial areas, where the freezing and thawing action is very prominent. This area witnessed the frost action and frost heave. Several types of landforms are also developed in this area. Thank you. Thank you very much.